beautiful, sunny downtown Los Angeles, City of Angels, and official site of the 1984 Summer Games, Not Necessarily the News presents this exclusive Olympic preview. You can almost feel the excitement in the air here in L.A. as the native Angelinos prepare to welcome athletes and visitors from around the world. Traffic is being skillfully rerouted to accommodate the expected influx of cars, campers, buses, and trucks. Many foreign contingents are already in town, rehearsing for the fabulous opening ceremonies. We'll meet some of the great athletes from around the world, here to compete for the gold. And we'll find out what they eat. So join us now for Not Necessarily the Olympics.
Good evening. I'm Bob Charles, and tonight, NNTN presents the most comprehensive preview of the upcoming 1984 Olympic Games. We'll look ahead to some of our top Olympic hopefuls. We'll go to every location where all the big events will take place, and we'll try to find out what the word venue means. But first, let's check in with our expert correspondents, who've all gathered at a favorite watering hole here in Los Angeles called the Shot Put. Hi, gang.
Oh, hi, Bob.
Hi.
Hi. Boy, it looks like you guys are having fun.
Oh, yeah.
We are. There's excitement in the air as the Olympics approach.
That's right, Frosty. And we're all especially excited because we're going to cover some fantastic athletic events. I'll be bringing you up-to-the-minute coverage of track and field in the men's and women's events and watch the contenders go for the gold.
I'll be at the dramatic gymnastic event. How about you, Frosty?
Oh, swimming, diving, maybe the most exciting events of the games. That's where I'll be.
Not this guy. I'll be covering basketball. You know, we've only ever lost once. I'll be there for every big...
Yeah. Oh, everybody, I should introduce the newest member of our news team, Ellen St. Thomas. Welcome.
Hello.
Hi, Ellen.
Oh, thank you. Well, believe me, it's really cool.
Oh, compadres.
Hey, Bobby.
Wow.
Right.
What are you doing here?
Well,
it looks like you guys are having such a good time. I decided to come over and join.
Oh,
I'm sorry. Forgive me. I interrupted. Go ahead, please.
Oh, well, Bob, all I wanted to say was how honored I am to be joining such a prestigious staff.
Here, here, Ellen. Ellen. It's our pleasure. Now, by the way, you didn't tell us what you're going to be covering.
Oh, the Russians.
Let's throw it back to the newsroom, shall we?
Tonight, Not Necessarily the Olympics is brought to you by Sherwin-Williams new caffeine-free house paint with NutriSweet and by Oil of Olay, the hand cream for matadors.
And now, this.
From the corners of the world they come, the bravest and the best, to write their names in history, to face the final test, and they gather as they've always done, with one purpose and one name, to give their souls and bodies to the challenge of the game.
Summing up, I expect the LA Olympics to be the best ever.
However, we do have a few problems. The Soviets will not be attending, and neither will the East Germans. So forget about weightlifting and swimming. The Cubans are out, so scratch boxing and some track. No East Europeans will put a damper on soccer and water polo. And of course, we can write off North Korea, Afghanistan, and Mongolia. Attendance will be way off, and the ratings could be a disaster. And we still have to worry about terrorist attacks.
This year, it's not just the athletes going for the gold. So for all those Olympic-sized headaches and Olympic-sized tummy aches that go with Olympic organizing, there is Alka-Seltzer. If you're already sick of the 84 Olympics, take Alka-Seltzer.
And now, an Olympic moment, brought to you by Bechtel. We're really the CIA. And by Getty Oil. We just bought Bechtel. Berlin, 1936. A canny American house cat challenges Hitler's master race theory by winning the gold medal in table tennis. The feline defeats all comers, including a strong German squad, without losing a single point. The Fuhrer is furious and vows to have ping pong eliminated as an Olympic event. A catastrophe for the Krauts. This has been an Olympic moment.
Standing in front of the training facility of the Olympics' newest competition, Olympic Donuts. Now, this exciting sport bears a close resemblance to Olympic basketball.
Two teams try to maintain possession of a large donut, maneuver it down to their own court, and slam dunk it home.
Another addition that promises to make the 84 Olympics the most exciting Olympics of all. That's a fact.
In the interest of giving this year's Olympics a distinctive Californian look, the officials have decided to make some changes in the attire and location for the volleyball competition. All matches will take place at Zuma Beach, and contestants will be required to wear skimpy bikinis. Tickets are reported to be selling very well.
This is Steve Casper at the White House.
President Reagan welcomed members of the U.S. Olympic handshake team to the White House today, calling them America's best at what they do. Meanwhile,
it's Red World of Sports with Vladimir Molotov and Dmitry Gogovich.
Good evening, comrades, and welcome to Red World of Sports. Our big story, of course, is Soviet bloc games. Already, preparations are underway in sunny Siberia, where citizens are working up sweat clearing the tennis courts.
Still a little chilly, but remember, it's only July. And now, here with comment on upcoming games, is our own Jimmy the Czech.
Hello, boys. Well, it's good you are having these games here in Russia. See, I have inside information that says the Russian team is very, very weak this year. It will be terrible embarrassment in real Olympics. This way, any Russian can win medal, eh?
Well, we won't be hearing any more from him.
Not unless there is sport show in the gulag.
Of course, anybody would be crazy to criticize this team with athletes on it like this one.
Oh. You are enlarging my head with your flattery.
Everybody knows you are shoo-in to win medal. Or else...
Not if I waste time talking when I should be exercising. I go.
Good luck. That was Anna Mustavsky, Russian hopeful in women's swimming.
And now we are taking closer look at reasons behind Soviet boycott of Summer Olympic Games.
For starters, American CIA has been rehearsing opening ceremonies and flag raising for months.
And our athletes would not have been safe on streets of Los Angeles, where pedestrians are often attacked by gang of roving cattle.
What is more, American entry in yachting competition poses dangerous threat to Soviet contestants.
And now, Vladimir, we are going, please, to capture training film for capitalist athletes.
Comrades, what you are about to be seeing is final reason for socialist boycott. We are thanking KGB for finding film. We are now rolling.
night, you meant.
Sure, baby.
Set!
After games, we go to Kansas, raise goats together.
Let's win the games, even if we have to cheat.
As you can see, a society deserving of boycott.
Soviet bloc games, on the other hand, will be sure to be very model of fairness. We will be starting off with our own, and may I say, better, Olympic torch.
The torch will start out in Moscow, but its destination is top secret. Don't even ask about it if you know it's good for you.
For track and field events, we are building giant stadium, 12 times larger than puny L.A. Coliseum. There will be swimming contests in virtually ice-free harbor at Murmansk. And graceful kayaking in safe and tranquil Petchora River.
All of our friends from the Third World will be there to compete in events like machine gun target shooting.
The team from Vietnam is expected to attend, as well as the always exciting Bulgarian gymnastics squad. And our friends from Poland, seen here competing in, what else, the pole vault.
And of course, we will be having many demonstration events, Soviet style.
Not excellent technique by Soviet team in baton pass.
So there you are having it, Vlad, an exciting summer of sports in Soviet Union.
And a few very boring days of unfair competition between warmongering NATO countries in large American city that is remaining nameless, if you are catching my drift.
So good night from Red World of Sports, and be sure to stay tuned for the Un-American Sportsman, coming up next, please, on all channels.
Red World of Sports has been brought to you by the Soviet Union, official boycotter of the 1984 Summer Olympics.
It was a wild and wet scene on San Pedro Bay today when sailors from Luxembourg, Liechtenstein, San Marino, Andorra, and 15 other tiny landlocked nations competed in the Olympic trials. Competitors who had seen water before had the advantage in the early going, but by the end of the day, the race had to be declared a draw.
Beset by war, has also been suffering through the worst drought in its history. Unfortunately, no one informed Iraq's top Olympic hopeful in the high dive, Uli al-Hassam. Hassam was not told that all non-essential use of water was strictly forbidden. Even though the government sent him a letter informing him of the new law, the letter was accidentally delivered to another Uli al-Hassam. Even though the Russians, the East Germans, the Czechs, and the Bulgarians will not be participating in these Olympics, at least Romania will be there. And when you mention Romania, one name always comes to mind.
Nadia Comăneci. In the 76 Olympics, she won 3 gold medals and the hearts of the world. In 1980, she got 2 more golds. And in 1984, she's really let herself go.
Nadia, you've seemed to change quite a bit since we've seen you last.
I've become much more a woman in the past 5 years. I had four beautiful children, and I got married recently, and people of Romania have been so very kind to me. They give me all, everything that I need, boiled potatoes, stuffed cabbage, blintzes, kasha.
I believe it's your turn to perform now, Nadia. Oh. Thank you very much. Good luck. Judges' scores are in. We have a 0.1, 0.0, 0.1, and a perfect 10 from the Romanian judge. And I'm Steve Casper.
With the Summer Olympics just days away, athletes from all around the world are training in high gear. And nowhere do they train harder than in sunny El Salvador. Let's take a closer look.
Toma la marca!
In women's swimming, the coaches have adopted a new strategy.
Well, see, to encourage speed and agility, we have placed mines in the pool. And if we still have a team, we're going to be very tough to beat.
From El Salvador, this is Helen St. Thomas.
Pretty good, huh?
The following Olympic moment is brought to you by Ennui, Cologne and Bath Oil. Melbourne, Australia, 1948. Over 100,000 packed Melbourne's Memorial Stadium, awaiting the start of the 14th Modern Olympiad, the first games to take place after the tragic conflagration known as the Second World War. Indeed, the games are to be a joyous celebration, a cherished memory for all who attend. But sadly, not for these avid sports fans, because the 1948 games were being held in London, not Melbourne. This has been another Olympic moment.
In basketball, the Italian team got a big boost from one of its biggest fans.
They are invincible. They are invincible.
The Pope went on to say that with the looser Olympic rules, his Italian boys would be able to throw their elbows around like it was a Pier 6 brawl. And then he boasted that the Americans were just a bunch of skinny wimps. And then, well, then he says some things that I really can't read over the air.
Meanwhile, over in the Pomona Valley this morning, a surprising development in the trials for the elimination breathing event. Chuck Smokey Stepner, a local favorite, was eliminated after breathing for only 20 minutes, leaving the field open for Ikura Iron Lungs Osawa of Tokyo.
Weightlifting. After the withdrawal of the Russians, no one expected much. Surprisingly, the Irish team have already broken records in the preliminaries. With me is Irish weightlifter Sean O'Grady. Sean, how do you account for the sudden Irish surge?
Well, Frosty, we are all the time practicing to bring glory to Mother Ireland. Oh, sure and begone. We are eating much potatoes and drinking of our good Irish vodka and, whiskey. And, of course, all the time we are singing. Oh, Danny boy. Defy.
With the Irish weightlifting team, I'm Frosty Kimmelman.
Glen to Glen, everybody, and on the mountains, on the mountains.
One of the big problems at any Olympic Games is housing, and that doesn't only mean the athletes.
Hello!
Bill Kimmelman!
Bienvenidos!
This summer, people from all over the world are coming to Los Angeles to see the Olympics.
People like Urt and Helga Barksen from Norway.
They're coming to watch their daughter, Kirsten, a Norwegian gymnast, and they'd do anything to find a nice place to stay near UCLA.
Of course, we live in a two-room hovel nowhere near UCLA, but it's closer to Norway. That's why we're charging them $400 a day, up front, in cash, and we're spending our summer in Santa Barbara. Now, come on.
We have more. Enjoy the spa.
Doctor!
To have put LSD in the water cooler used by the U.S. Olympic volleyball team. The U.S. team, which had been favored, will now be lucky to finish fifth. Now this.
Why waste time, travel, and money trying to attend this year's Olympics when you can have all the excitement in the privacy of your home with Rich Hall's Budget Home Olympics? Budget Home Olympics lets you turn any household clock into an Olympic event. For instance, real fencing is rigid, boring, but Budget Home Fencing turns it into a first-rate action chase adventure. This home diving platform has all the excitement of real diving, plus a built-in penalty arm for those divers who take a little too long to leave the board. And just look at this home boxing ring. 12 rounds, built-in bell. This is the kind of excitement that'll have everyone on the edges of their seats. Order yours today and enjoy Olympic excitement day in and day out. Year in and year out. Budget Home Olympics.
Two stories making news at this hour. The Olympic torch continues its zigzag journey across the United States today, with thousands of runners participating in this truly marathon trek. The route so far has taken the torch through the lush hills of Virginia, the pine forests of Georgia, the bayous of Louisiana, and the oil fields of Texas. In an unrelated story, authorities are now saying they believe arson is the cause for those terribly destructive fires raging out of control in Virginia, Georgia, Louisiana, and Texas. And now, for another one of those stupid Olympic moments.
This Olympic moment is brought to you by Pars Easter Egg Dye. It's not just for Easter anymore. Paris, 1924, the finals of the women's 10-meter platform dive. For the first time in modern Olympics history, no one is awarded a medal. The event is later discontinued, considered too difficult for women. This has been another Olympic moment.
Well, it looks like those devious Russians will stop at nothing in their attempts to sabotage this year's Olympic Games. It seems that last night someone replaced all the discuses for the track and field trials with large pieces of cow manure. Olympic organizers were quoted as saying that they didn't find this prank even remotely amusing.
One unfortunate note we must add. Swedish cameraman Ulf Nordström, here to cover his first Olympics, apparently misunderstood something NNTN reporter Steve Casper said to him, and becoming suddenly despondent, and before anyone could talk him out of it, leaped to his death off Mount Wilson. Ulf Nordström will always be remembered as a moody, introspective, suicidal maniac. Now this.
I'm standing in front of the Olympic Cafe, the feeding facility for the over 4,000 athletes and trainers who will visit L.A. this year. Now, one item you won't find on the menu, Russian dressing. A drastic measure? Maybe. But after Russia's slap in the face, it had to be done. Last week at an emergency summit, a consortium of leaders, past and present, met to sample possible replacements for the popular dressing. Gerald Ford suggested a tangy Roquefort. Alex Haig went with Green Goddess. And boycott expert Jimmy Carter proposed a piquant peanut tahini. Finally, President Reagan stepped in and settled the dispute. Ranch dressing would be the official dressing of the 84 Olympics. So athletes from around the world can be assured that in 1984, their salads will be as flavorful and as zesty as always. I'm Rich Hall.
Let's eat.
This portion of Not Necessarily the Olympics was brought to you by Busby's. When it comes to speed, strength, and endurance, good nutrition is essential. And that means starting every day with the nutritious cereal you know you can trust. Busby's brand cereal. 100% brand. For regular performance every time, Busby's brand keeps you running. And by Anabolic Steroid, the official drug of the 1984 Summer Olympics.
It has been my privilege, no, my honor, to bring you this Olympic preview. To be the conduit between you, the viewer, and them, the athletes. It has been my role to be a window through which you have seen the unfolding drama of athletic competition. A plain sheet of glass, perhaps slightly tinted, to filter out the mundane and let in the spectacular. A lens to focus in on the essential and cast aside the trivial, like so much putrid garbage. To select, to shape, to mold, to exercise judgment. To decide what you will see and what you won't see. What you will hear and when you will hear it. I am your eyes. I am your ears. I am the Olympics.